Spinal adjustments provided by Dr. Chad Rolfson. The Spinal Tuning Chiropractic Center is a Des Moines area low flat fee per month unlimited chiropractic care practice. When life happens, just adjust. Schedule today at SpinalTuning.com.
Here's your Daily Planet for Tuesday, August 25th, 2020. I'm Jimmy Olsen. The Nutty Professor, it's getting another reboot, but there are no details yet. Jerry Lewis, he was the original Nutty Professor in 1963. Then Eddie Murphy did the first remake in 1996, followed by a sequel in 2000. Taron Egerton is downplaying the talk that he'll be the next Wolverine. He says, quote, "I love Marvel, but it's just fan stuff. There is no grounding for those rumors." The CW developing a live-action version of the Powderpuff Girls, where the girls are 20-somethings disillusioned with the way that they lost their childhood to crime fighting, but have to decide whether to reunite. Jason Aldean, Brett Young, and Maddie and Tay will be performing at a Backyard Beach concert. It's streaming for free this Friday on the Live Nation Virtual Concert Hub. Wiz Khalifa is launching a delivery-only restaurant chain in October called Hot Box by Wiz. Initially, it's only going to be available in a handful of cities like New York, L.A., and Wiz's hometown of Pittsburgh, but they plan on expanding. Amy Poehler is making a documentary about the personal and professional relationship of Lucille Ball and Desi Arnaz. A.J. McLean from the Backstreet Boys might be doing Dancing with the Stars. Goo Goo Dolls fans, they're going to be releasing their first Christmas album in October. A few random facts for your Tuesday. Smucker's actually cuts the crust off normal sandwiches to make Uncrustables. Then they send the crust out to be used as animal feed. Microsoft put Solitaire and Minesweeper in early versions of Windows to teach people how to use the mouse and click. Grocery stores sell a total of $5.5 billion worth of impulse buy items at the checkout line every single year. Wyoming was the last state to change its legal drinking age to 21. They didn't make it a law, though, until 1988. In 1947, a plane carrying 11 people crashed over the Andes Mountains in Argentina. Now, before crashing, they sent out the word Standec, S-T-E-N-D-E-C, in Morse code. The full wreckage has never been found, and no one knows what Standec means. Interesting tidbit, did you know that you will flush $11,198 worth of toilet paper in your lifetime? Starbucks has launched a new phone hotline that plays fall sounds, so if you call 1-833-GET-FALL, you can hear sounds like head out on a hayride or cozy up with your cup of coffee. Are you ready for their pumpkin spice latte? Domino's just launched two new pizza mashups. One is a cheeseburger pizza that uses ketchup and mustard sauce and has ground beef on top, and one's a taco pizza with chicken peppers and taco seasoning. If you're celebrating a birthday today, happy birthday. You're sharing your birthday with China Ann McClain, 22. She was Jennifer Pierce on Black Lightning. Also, Blake Lively, 33. Rachel Bilson is 39. Kel Mitchell, 42. Jonathan Togo, 43. Alexander Skarsgård is 44. Melvin Harrison, 48. Jody Messina, country singer, is 50. Robert Horry is 50. Claudia Schiffer is 50. Rachel Ray, 52. DJ Terminator X from Public Enemy is 54. Blair Underwood is 56. Shot G from Digital Underground is 57. Billy Ray Cyrus is 59. Joanne Wally is 59. Tim Burton, 62. Elvis Costello is 66. Rob Halford from Judas Priest is 69. Gene Simmons from Kiss, 71. John Savage, 71. Raleigh Fingers is 74. Tom Skerritt, 87. Sean Connery, Bond, James Bond, 90. Today is National Banana Split Day. It was on this date in 1939, The Wizard of Oz opened in theaters, starring Judy Garland as Dorothy. It was on this date, 1962, Little Eva hit number one with The Locomotion. It was on this date, 1970, Elton John played his first U.S. show at the famous Troubadour Club in Los Angeles. It was on this date, 1975, that Bruce Springsteen released his third album, Born to Run, which included Thunder Road, She's the One, and Jungle Land. This date, 1976, Boston released their self-titled album featuring More Than a Feeling, Peace of Mind, and Foreplay Long Time. 1986, Paul Simon released Graceland. It was on this date, 1994, that Robert Plant and Jimmy Page reunited in a London studio to record their MTV Unplugged show, which they cleverly called Unleaded. On this date, 1998, that Lauryn Hall from the Fugees released her debut solo album, The Miseducation of Lauryn Hill. So on this date in 2014, the Ariana Grande released her second album, My Everything, which included Problem. That's your Daily Planet for Tuesday, August 25th, 2020. I'm Jimmy Olsen. If you enjoyed this, be sure to share the podcast with your friends. You can always subscribe wherever you listen to your favorite podcast. Also find these stories and many more by following me on social media. It's My Buddy Jimmy, both Facebook and Twitter. You can also subscribe to my YouTube page for this podcast and many more as well, which is My Buddy Jimmy 101.